An exciting home opener for Lipscomb. They win in overtime over SEMO 80-74. Courtside, Jonathan and Justin Seaman, and we are joined by the Tarkenton and Harwell player of the game. Two great games against SEMO back-to-back. Jake Wolf, Jake, what a game. After a little scrummage there at midcourt and a couple of technicals, you kind of turned it on. They just kept sending you and sending you to the free throw line.
Yeah, they did. I felt like I had a mismatch pretty much the whole game. And I felt like I could drive most of their guys, so I think that was part of that. So I was just getting on the line. I wanted to hit them, so I wanted to win that game, especially after those calls.
You've had a long break. You had the surgery after having to end the season early last year in January. Didn't get to start practicing to October. How good a feeling is it to be playing basketball?
Yeah, I really can't describe it. I broke down into tears in the locker room. I'm so excited to be out here with the guys. It feels so good to be back, and I gotta praise God just for getting me back here.
Well, Jake, walk me through. There's about 11 seconds left. You're down by three. Couldn't tell, but it didn't look like you were the first option on that final shot, but you made it count.
Yeah, it was actually for Carson Carey. But he, you know, they came up on him, and I went behind and got the ball, and I knew I was gonna hit it when I shot it.
I was gonna say, couldn't you tell when it left your hand it was going in?
Yeah, it felt good. It felt good.
Walk me through a little bit of kind of the psyche of the team. This is a game where you have the big lead in the second half. You're up by 15, but then your two bigs go down with fouls. Parker Hazen gets out with fouls, and then Asajula goes down. All of a sudden, you're working from the three position. Now you're having to play the five spot, kind of being the distributor. How'd you guys kind of rally around that situation?
Yeah, like I said, I feel like I'm strong enough to defend against those guys. I work hard, so I tried to front them, and I knew my guys had my back on the back side. So it was really just a whole team effort. Couldn't have done it without any of the guys behind me. So we really just wanted to fight and get that win for Hassan and Parker.
Yeah, you were in a situation where you had to be the distributor up front on the offense, but then you had to play against Taylor quite a bit, and then it appeared that they went small with you guys, and then that was just a battle with both teams being small.
Yeah, it for sure was. It for sure was.
All right, good win under your belt tonight, but it doesn't hang a long run. You got Belmont coming in here on Saturday night.
Yes, sir. We'll be ready.
All right, congratulations, Jake. Great game tonight. Let's take a look at the Tarlington-Harwell listing of the game as we take a look at the stats here. Ended up Lipscomb wins it in overtime, 80-74. Lipscomb a little bit of advantage in field goal shooting, three-point shooting, a bigger advantage, 45-35. Man, did the Bisons get out rebound. SEMO 41-25. But look at the turnovers. 21 turnovers for SEMO tonight. Lipscomb got 30 points off those turnovers as Coach Lenny Acuff is joining us over at his broadcast position in just a moment. Due to all this social distancing, we are doing everything a little bit different. Coach, you're all the way across the gym. I'm not sure when I'll actually get really face-to-face with you.
Yeah.
Maybe before this season's over.
I tell you, it's nice to take the mask off because nobody's around me.
Yeah, we still have ours on over here.
Yeah, I tell you, how about that?
What a game, Coach. What a game.
Yeah, well, I guess Hutt sent something out. There hadn't been anything in this building in 270-something days. That's a heck of a way to bring it back, isn't it?
It is. You know, Coach, look at it this way. You had a 15-point lead. Then all of a sudden you're down nine. Then they call a couple technicals at midcourt that no one understands. And then after that, it became the Jake Wolf free throw shooting game.
Well, I tell you guys, I told him and all the guys, if you could have saw our locker room, how happy they were for Jake. You know, this is my 31st year as a head coach in college. And that's the guttiest performance I've ever seen by a kid. And there's no exaggeration. That's no making it more. I mean, he was like, Coach, I can't walk. And he just kept going. I mean, we didn't have another big man. I mean, like, we've had a lot of those guys out because of COVID protocol. And we lose Hassan and Parker in like 2 minutes time. And I can say, okay, Jake, you're the center. And, man, was he unbelievable. And how about that shot he made to win the game?
It was unbelievable, Coach, to tie the game and then get us into overtime. I was going to say, a lot of times we talk about how preseason games prepare for the conference. If you ever get in a situation without your big man, this game prepared you, I guess, a little bit. But you don't like to be in those situations.
You know, I pray, Jonathan, we never have to do that again. I mean, I say we punt that. But I'm really, really proud of all of our guys. I think, Greg Jones has been playing great basketball all year, and he was good again tonight. the two guys I think we really have to make sure we recognize, I thought Alex Jones, that's the best game I've seen him play in the 2 years I've been here. And then I thought Carson Carey, he makes a huge three, he takes a charge, and then he gets a steal, and then he gets a rebound. And he's the one that threw it back to Jake on that last shot. And, you know, we were fortunate. I mean, you know, that's a, you know, that you're going to score there 1 out of 10 times. But I have a lot of respect for Simo. I think Coach is doing a great job with them, Brad, and they're going to be a really, really tough out. They're not what they've been. They've really brought in good players, and there's a high buy-in with them.
Yeah, they're going to be really good as the season goes on. But I agree with you 100%. You got a lot of guys on this team that stepped up and played from maybe places they weren't playing. But I love seeing that team run there together after that bucket tied this game, set it in overtime.
Yeah, we've really grown. It's been hard. I'm not going to lie. I mean, this whole thing has been really, really, really difficult. And, hey, I was glad Tommy got in tonight. That was his first. He has practiced zero. He has not practiced in 3 weeks. And I was like, and I told him, I said, now I'm going to dress you because yesterday's the first day he could be out. And I said, now, if we get an emergency, we're going to put you in. And we had an emergency, and I thought he did a nice job. He's going to be a good player for us.
Well Coach, one other thing I want to talk about, because I thought, you know, with all the things going on, if you could actually kind of set up a non-conference series like this, this is pretty good foreshadowing for what you're going to see in conference play. How did that work out for your team just as far as preparation goes? Because this is what it's going to be like here in a few weeks.
Yeah, they do remind you of an A-Sun team, don't they, Justin? They do. They're kind of a North Alabama, Jacksonville, real tough physical team with really good guard play. And, you know, I think, too, I need to say this. Kevin Carroll and Tyler Murray, they kind of did the scout together. Roger will do Belmont on Saturday. I thought they had – our plan was great until we got in foul trouble. We really guarded in the first half, but you're right. It really makes us, it stretches us, it makes us, you know, I tell you what, we've had six hard-nosed games, and, you know, really we've had a chance to win every one of them but the Arkansas game, and I'm just proud of our guys for hanging in there.
Yeah, I think that's the tough thing, Coach. You had chances to win them, and when you don't win them, that really gets a team down. And without this comeback win tonight, it could have been really tough on this team. Now you got some momentum. Saturday night, only time you're supposed to meet this year, Battle of the Boulevard. I don't know what else we say.
Yeah, you know, Casey's doing a great job over there. They're really, 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 really good. I watched them last night. My goodness, are they good. And that'll be tough for us, but we're gonna try to get a little sleep tonight. We've got a team that's really, really tired, obviously. But we're gonna fight, and we'll be ready to play on Saturday. We have a ton of respect for them, and we're thankful to play, guys. You know, there's like 80 Division I teams or whatever it is haven't even played a game, and that was our sixth tonight. So, my hat's off to all the, you know, the people, our medical staff and our administration who've done an amazing job so that we did have a chance to get to the floor.
Coach, it started here tonight. I've been around Lipscomb basketball since it began, I think. I don't think I ever remember a 7-game home stand.
Well, I tell you what, I'm signing up for it. I told them tonight, I walked in, they had on their white uniforms. I said, we haven't wore our whites. They said, oh, yeah, Coach, we wore our whites against Lamar on a neutral court. And they said, we're undefeated in white. And I said, thank goodness for the white unis. So we get to wear them for a while.
Congratulations here, Coach. We'll see you Saturday
night.
Thank
you, guys. I appreciate y'all so much. Have a good night.
Hey, we appreciate you. Great win tonight in overtime. Lipscomb wins it over Simo here, 80-74. They'll get set for Belmont on Saturday night, 7 o'clock game on ESPN+, and you can see it there. A lot of home games to follow. You stick with them. You can keep up with everything related to Lipscomb Athletics at LipscombSports.com.